Okay, we are here to talk turkey. Specifically, how to roast the perfect turkey. I know a lot of people think that roasting breast down is the best way, or possibly spatchcocking, which I've done before and it does make a really, really good turkey, or basting every 30 minutes. There's lots of different ways that people say will make the best turkey. However, in my, I don't know, 15 years of cooking turkey, using a turkey roaster, which is over here, that's what we're gonna do, is probably my favorite, quickest, easiest, and honestly, the best way to make a really tender and juicy turkey, kind of no fail. So I've already prepared everything that I'm gonna put inside of the turkey prior to getting the turkey ready. I have also rinsed and patted dry the turkey. So a lot of people say don't put salt inside your turkey. I don't necessarily agree with that. I've never had a problem. So I'm gonna put in the salt and pepper. It's about 2 teaspoons of salt and about 1 teaspoon of pepper. Kind of just throw it in there, make sure it's evenly distributed. And then right here I'm gonna put 1.5 carrots that I've chopped in half and then also just washed. I am going to, and this is all in the, I guess this would be the, I don't know, I guess the main cavity of the turkey. I'm also going to put 3 cloves of garlic, make it 4. I'm going to put in 3 dry bay leaves. I'm going to put in about 1/2 a large onion, and then I'm going to put in 2 stalks of celery that have been washed and halved. It's a good start. And then also in the bottom cavity right here, I'm going to put some more. There's not much room here, but I always like to put a little bit of onion, garlic, bay leaf, kind of whatever you can squeeze in that bad boy, because it makes it have more flavor throughout, and then also the drippings that you get are just going to be better. So now you've got that all done, how are you gonna hold it together? Truss the turkey. I am not by any means like a master trusser, so I apologize if you know how to do it better. I start by putting it underneath the back half of the turkey, wrapping it around the wing on either side, pulling forward like this, coming back down around and under the turkey, coming back up to each of the legs, wrapping each of the legs a couple of times, coming back, and then tying the legs together. Basically just keeping the turkey together so that it doesn't stick to the side of the pan, or, and it also helps everything kind of evenly cook. You can have a big bow. This is just basic butcher string, so nothing fancy or hard to find. You can find it usually even at the grocery store. Not a big deal. So now we're to the point where a roaster definitely does not create that like perfectly brown kind of Martha Stewart kind of turkey. And so I'm gonna show you how to do that in just a second. Okay, so now to get that perfectly browned turkey. I read somewhere, I don't remember when, to use just the kind of a browning sauce. I think it's just called Kitchen Bouquet. And it really does exactly that. It just browns your turkey. So just make sure your turkey is dry. And then you just kind of paint your turkey. I sometimes sing it to the tune of Painting Your Roses Red from Alice in Wonderland. I will not subject any of you to that today because I like you all enough not to. So you just go through and evenly paint the turkey. Okay, so as you can see, I've kind of coated all of the turkey with the browning sauce. One thing I love on poultry is to sprinkle just a little paprika. This also will help with the overall color in the end, and it just really adds a nice kind of earthy taste in the end, and also for your gravy later with all of the drippings. So just kind of sprinkle that on. I don't really use an exact amount, so I apologize. And then I also, again, some people will disagree, but I like to do a little salt and also some pepper on the outside of the bird. So we're almost done. One thing that I've always found is my favorite tool is one of these little flavor injectors. I love to inject the poultry with some broth that is infused with a little garlic and onion. I think it adds a nice flavor and also helps keep it juicy. I'm not sure if that's a fact or not, but if for nothing else but the flavor, it's really good. So just take your flavor injector, stab your turkey in a few spots. I definitely pay close attention to the breast because the breast cooks fastest. It's also the one place that's most likely to get a little bit dry. So I definitely try to puff up and inject the breast quite frequently and pay close attention to just kind of get it into the meat and not too deep, because then you're just kind of injecting the inside of the turkey with it also. Oops, and sometimes that happens. And then also, just I also like to go, just for good measure, give some to the leg too. I just really believe that you can't have too juicy of a bird, to be quite honest with you. And almost done. And there we go. So now the turkey is all ready to go in the roaster. The roaster has been, has about a cup of broth in it. You can use homemade or not homemade. And it has been preheated to 350. You don't use a rack or anything. You're going to put the bird directly into the roaster. So just, I mean, there's no good or probably sanitary way to do this, in my opinion. So I'm just going to lift up this bad boy and then plop him in the roaster. And be careful when you're doing that so you don't touch the sides and possibly hurt yourself. So there you go. Your bird is in the roaster. And this is about a 12.5-pound bird. You cook it for about 12 minutes. So in about 2.5 hours, you're going to have a perfectly cooked bird. And I hope that this lesson helped you a little bit. Talk to you later. Bye.